A Muntinlupa court grants demurrer of former Senator Leila De Lima in her last remaining drug case. This effectively dismisses her last drug case. De Lima, a staunch critic of the Duterte administration's anti-narcotics campaign, was released on bail in November after nearly 7 years in detention. Human rights groups have branded the drug charges filed during the Duterte administration as politically motivated. De Lima expressed gratefulness for her vindication and issued a warning to former President Rodrigo Duterte.
Ito po ang message ko sa dating Pangulo, kay Ginoong Duterte. Kayo ngayon ang mananagot sa mga kasalanan niyo sa taong bayan. Isa lang po akong biktima. Libo-libo mga Pilipino ang pinaslang nila noong nakaraang madugo at peking war on drugs. Sa mga sumusuporta po sa akin, huwag po kayong mawawala. Dahil pagkatapos ng 7 taon, mas handa po ako na ituloy ang laban.
We're now joined by De Lima's lawyer, Attorney Philbon Tacardon. Attorney Tacardon, welcome to Top Story. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir, and good afternoon to all your listeners.
Okay.
Thank you for this opportunity, sir.
Yeah, it's good to have you here. I know it's a busy schedule for you and the former senator, but yeah, please tell us a bit about the case, the insights as to the decision of the court saying that, you know, it lacked evidence and finally dismissing those charges and cases against the former senator.
Yes, this is the third and last drug case where the former senator Leila De Lima was accused of conspiring and collaborating with inmates from the National Bilibid Prison in the illegal drug trade inside the prison. So the top witness in this case is the inmate Herbert Culanco, who claimed that he delivered a total of 120 million pesos to Senator Leila De Lima as her share in the process of the illegal drug trade. However, during the trial, it was established that there was no conspiracy between Senator Leila De Lima, her co-accused in this case, and even with the inmate. And the court said that the failure of the prosecution to establish conspiracy means that Senator Leila is not really involved in this illegal drug trade and should be acquitted of the charges filed against her. So that's basically the reason why Senator Leila De Lima was the mirror to evidence was granted, and Senator Leila De Lima is deemed acquitted of the charges filed against her.
And is this decision final and executory, or do you anticipate that, you know, the prosecution side would still contest this?
Well, the granting of the demurrer to evidence is tantamount to an acquittal.
Okay.
And under our constitution, the acquittal of the accused, once an accused is acquitted of the criminal charges, double jeopardy sets in, and the same is no longer appealable. So we are expecting, this case, the decision is already final and executory as far as the defense team of Senator Leila De Lima is concerned, and that the case cannot be appealed before any appellate court.
Okay, earlier on the show we aired videos of the former senator. She seemed very happy, very satisfied with the decision. She also mentioned one thing about her accusers, the former president of the Philippines, Rodrigo Duterte, saying that, you know, she would exact justice from what happened to her in the last 7 years. Could you describe to us the next steps, perhaps, for the former senator in this regard?
Oh, actually, sir, this is also the first time that I heard it from the former senator.
Okay.
Even before, after she was released on bail, people were asking about her next step moving forward, and but she was a bit silent on it, and she preferred that the same be discussed after the case was dismissed. So the truth is, we never discussed any legal step at this time.
Okay.
But with that statement, I'm sure she's planning somehow. She has her own plan somehow moving forward in this case.
All right. And perhaps is it possible that this is something extrajudicial? Because, you know, she might have been vocal about assisting or, you know, supporting any probe into the drug wars, especially by international bodies.
Well she's actively involved with this case before the ICC. So nothing has changed so far as Senator Leila de Lima's participation in that case. And of course there will be a judicial proceeding because from the statement coming from the former senator, she would want the former president to pay for quote-unquote his crimes against the Filipino people.
Okay. Attorney Takardon, you know, the last 7 years have been very difficult for the former senator. What kind of justice is she actually seeing from her accusers, from the former administration?
Well, it's not only justice for herself. She's also seeking justice for all the victims of the extrajudicial killings, justice for the victims of the fake drug wars, which she described as a fake drug war. So at this time, as I said, no details. I cannot give you any details at this time. And for sure, if there will be plans, the Filipino people will be able to know about it.
And lastly, where is the good senator now? And what are the activities related to these developments within the day?
Well, there is an impromptu victory party that we're here now in an impromptu victory party. And he just arrived coming from her house. And that for the rest of the day, I think we will just be reminiscing what we have done in that case and maybe exchange jokes and banter about it.
Okay.
We're just enjoying the day.
Okay, Attorney Takardon, I'm sure you've discussed with the former senator about possibilities, including what happened today and perhaps the next steps, even just broad strokes of what she will undertake in the next couple of days, if you can give us an idea of what these are.
Well, as I said, we have not discussed anything formal and no details as of yet.
Okay.
Before today, we were actually preparing for the worst scenario. For the worst scenario that will happen in case, or the scenario in case the demurrer is denied. So our focus was on that, and we were not able to discuss anything so far as her next step moving forward.
All right. On that note, Attorney Philbon Takardon, lawyer for former Senator Leila de Lima, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, for sharing the developments from your end.
Yeah, thank you.
All right.